Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch Sheet Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in for another video without mid-roll ads. Yeah, and in this video, we're gonna have a look at the content of this here box from iFlight. This box contains the IH2 HD, so a DJI digital FPV drone. This is a bit of a weird quadcopter. Not that the product itself is weird, but there's very little activity around this quadcopter online. Hardly any reviews, no reviews maybe even. And iFlight doesn't promote this quadcopter, Banggood doesn't promote this quadcopter. I do not understand why, because it should, from the looks of it, be a very versatile quadcopter. I ordered it with my own money. And also, I should state that I've told iFlight that the box is a little bit, well, you can see that it's a little squashed. I've told them that the box should be a little better, also a little bigger maybe. And I've told Banggood that it's a little pricey. Yeah, might be the reason for it being not popular online, I'm not sure. However, because I told Banggood it's too pricey, they've lowered the price. So if you are interested in this IH2 HD, I've saved you approximately $40. There. Okay, in this video we're gonna have a look at content of the box, obviously, see if there's, if the quadcopter looks alright. We're gonna have a look if the configuration looks well done. And we're gonna do one test flight with it. After that, I'll put this quadcopter in my test fleet, if you will. Do let's say 30, 40 flights. And then I'll come back to you with my review of it. So let's have a look how this quadcopter is packaged. Okay, we got some decals, which is always appreciated, thank you very much. We've got, from the looks of it, documentation. Yeah, so the IH2 I have here has a receiver in it already. However, you can order it without a receiver, and this diagram shows you, well, how everything is connected, really. Is that correct? Yeah, receivers, VTXs, everything down to the camera. I hope you'll be able to see that. So your technical documentation is here on this sheet. Should be enough. Then we've got strap and some battery anti-slip mat from the looks of it. More decals, pretty nice. We've got extra propellers. And these are actually different propellers than the ones that are already on the quadcopter, as you'll see. And you know what? I'm gonna take everything out of this box. However, I should add that I think the quadcopter isn't... I told you already, right? I think the packaging is a little substandard. Yeah. Especially with these extra prop guards. I do appreciate getting extra prop guards, obviously, but they're loose in the box like this. Oh well, maybe I'm nitpicking. You tell me. I'm gonna take everything out of this box and then I'll show you what we got. Here we go. All right, we got the quadcopter itself, obviously, the IH2 HD. And a very nice quadcopter. More on this quadcopter in a second. We get, you've already seen this decal sheet, very, very nice. Technical documentation. We get an extra, is this extra? Yeah, this is an extra strap, or maybe to strap down an action camera. You don't get an action camera mount, by the way. We get two anti-slip mats, so one spare, I guess. We get, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see this. What are these, gummies or... These look to be spare stick bolts. Really hard to show you because they are transparent. Anyway, some spare hardware. Always appreciated. More spare hardware, screws. And these are probably screws to secure down the propellers. But these are spares. Then we got some frame spare screws. Very much appreciated. Nice. I like seeing spare screws. More spare screws. Very, very nice, actually. And again, some more decals. We get, what is this? The documentation of the Vista set, the Caddx Vista camera setup. We get some antenna tubes, because mine came with a receiver. Well, I guess, I think you get these antenna tubes regardless. And let me see, we get spare propeller guards, four spare propeller guards, very, very nice. They are definitely the same as the ones that are on the quadcopter already. However, as you can see on the quadcopter, they have decals on them and the spare ones don't. However, you get a sheet of these decals and actually eight of them. So that's very, very nice. We also get this USB right angle adapter, which is very, very important. Yeah, without this, you'd have to take the quadcopter apart every time you wanna hook it up to Betaflight. And more on this in a second. Now, prop cards, right? However, you can also run this quadcopter with bigger propellers and then without the propeller guards, which is where these propellers come in. So these, the stock propellers, are Emacs Evens? No, not Evens. I'm not sure what these are called. Scimitar. Yeah, okay. Emacs Scimitar propellers, however, these are 2.5 inch and these, the black ones, are 3 inch. So basically, you have two quadcopters in one, which is, well, part of the reason why I don't really understand why it's not more popular. Again, two quadcopters in one, that should be nice. So the IH2, which should have been called the IH2.5 maybe, or the IH, anyway, a 2.5 inch and 3 inch quadcopter all in one, and it's a DJI digital setup. Very, very nice. So this frame has an H style of configuration, as you can see here, and I must say it feels a lot sturdier than I had expected. I had expected the arms to be a little thin maybe, but there is not a whole lot of flex in the quadcopter itself. There is a little bit of flex in the prop cards, which is a good thing, of course. They should have a little bit of give. And I will actually be flying the quadcopter as you see it here in most of my flights to test it like it is. I think if you'd want to run this quadcopter in 3 inch, you can, but I'm not completely sure why you then ordered this quadcopter. So I'll again be mostly testing the quadcopter as is with the 2.5 inch propellers. Now, with most of the smaller quadcopters with the Vista set, you have a hard time accessing the USB port or even USB ports, right? You've got two USB ports, one for the Vista set itself over here and one for your flight stack, your flight controller over there. Now, the quadcopter comes with this right angle adapter, right? Which is a micro USB right angle adapter. So with that, you can actually hook up the flight controller for a Betaflight configuration. However, there's no right angle adapter for the USB-C port on the Vista set. Yeah, so lucky for all of us, you don't get monthly updates to the Vista set or the DJI system. But every now and again, you will actually have to take off this motor over here and the prop card to update the firmware and, well, that's it, basically. You will initially have to activate your Vista set, obviously, as with all DJI systems. So again, you'll have to take off 4 screws. Not a biggie. It's a bit awkward. And I think they should have included a USB-C version of this as well, or only a USB-C version, and then include a flight controller stack with a USB C port. So yeah, that's for now actually my only complaint, other than the packaging being a little meh for a $300 quadcopter, or actually even 300 euros when I ordered mine. By now, again, it's a little less expensive. About the price, when I ordered it, I definitely thought, that's a little bit, and that's an understatement, a little bit expensive. I think it was definitely too expensive when I ordered it. By now, it's borderline expensive. But we'll see. Maybe if the quadcopter works out very, very well, We'll see, right? Speaking of, I don't want to waste more of your time than needed. This is not the end review, right? So let's get into the flights. And in my final review of this quadcopter, I'll tell you more on my findings of it. So let's do some flying. All right, guys, here we go. Made a flight for the iFlight IH2HD. And am I recording? Yeah, looks like I'm recording. Okay, so in case you are wondering, this is genuinely my first flight with this quadcopter, so let's get used to it a little bit. The first thing I noticed when I took off is that the first half of the throttle range doesn't do a whole lot. Yeah, I am at 60% throttle now, I assume, and this is hovering. And that doesn't mean that the quadcopter is underpowered or anything, but simply that, well, most of its grunt seems to be in the upper half of the throttle range. That's fine. Maybe I'll add a throttle curve to the profile in my radio for this quadcopter. Also, 1 minute. I'm flying the quadcopter on a 650 milliamp hour 4S LiPo, which is more than iFlight suggests for the quadcopter, right? They suggest a 450, and again, this is a 640, or 650, sorry. So that's heavier, and that might be part of the reason why it doesn't have a whole lot of get up and go in the first 50%. Above 50% though, it's fine. I've angled the FV camera down, up a little bit. So right out of the box, this quadcopter will be a little slower. I am kind of already used to the quadcopter. Now in public channel, select a player channel. Okay, oh. I hope my goggle is actually recording. This is pleasant to fly, this quadcopter. Not bad at all, actually. I hope the FV experience for you will be good as well. I do see some JPEG artifacts now and again, and I'm at 25 megabits per second. I'm not sure why. Maybe because I'm on a public channel. Can I switch channels in flight? I don't know. Weird. I'm not sure why I am on a public channel. You know what? I'm gonna set the quadcopter down for a sec and play around with those channels for a minute to see if I can up the megabits per second. Again, it's now at 25 and it should be able to run at 50. Okay, can I take off from grass? Let's try again. And nothing has changed. Now in a public channel. Okay, the people that are more familiar with DJI FPV will probably be telling me what to do. And yeah, you can't see that error message. But in my goggle, I get the message. Now in a public channel, select a player channel. I've tried to, but oh well. Doesn't matter. This is, this is no longer the main of flight, I guess. Ooh, the rates are pretty high. Whew. Unexpected. Pretty high rates, okay. Huh, very responsive. And yeah, again, I'm pretty much used to the quadcopter already. And so this DJI stuff doesn't record audio, so let's fly around the GoPro for a bit so you can hear.
I don't think it's super noisy. It's not the most quiet quadcopter I've ever flown. But it's pretty okay. Definitely not a noisy beast, this quadcopter. Pretty nice. Let's see if I can run this goal over here. Yeah, I can. Yeah, I do have, again, some JPEG artifacts. Bitrate low, 25 megabits. So I guess this is the old way of flying DJI. And I obviously did update the firmware. Both my goggle and the quadcopter. And it should be able to run at 50 megabits per second, but oh well, doesn't really matter. Oh, my LiPo is done for. No more power, yeah. Okay. So, guys, that was the maiden flight with this iFlight IH2 HD. It flies well, better than expected, actually. I couldn't really feel that the quadcopter has prop guards. Yeah, the throttle curve, that I'll need to look into. Just like the bitrate, that's well, something for me to look into. That's not a quadcopter's fault, obviously. So what I'll do now is, again, put this quadcopter into my test fleet, and in a week maybe, I'll come back to you with my findings on this iFlight IH2 HD. If you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.